you woke up from a curious and there were whirling shapes and swirling suns, and I wasn't lonely. I woke up from a wonderful dream, woke full of energy and hunger, and now this hunger will be still, and my emptiness be filled, as I sat about you.
platter for the wrists.
Ask so many questions.
Why not?
Look, it's called the Tree of Knowledge, and the fruit must never ever be eaten or touched. Is that understood?
We understand, Father. We won't touch it.
Why not?
Children, if you love me, if you love this family, you will never ever eat of that fruit. Both of you.
We promise, Father.
We promise.
Thank you.
But if it isn't good for us, Father, why did you put it there? Why can't we know everything you know?
Look, I know. Let's play a game.
What sort of game?
A naming game.
Naming what?
There's only her, Eve, and me, Adam.
And?
Oh, what's that?
Aha!
Look, another one!
What are they?
They're animals.
Animals?
Yes, and you, my children, must help me care for them.
They can be our children.
That's a good idea. They can be your children.
I'll take care of this one, and Ethan have that one over there.
Oh, no, 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 Adam. There is more than one apiece.
Where? Why can't we see them?
Oh, because they're shy. You have to call them. Like this. Oh!
I will never be done. you.
Oh, that's all right. You'll finish tomorrow. Now, it's bedtime.
Oh, why can't we stay up later?
No more questions, daughter Eve. Come on.
With the dawn, and smile with the dawn. watch you for a while now, my pretty little miss.
And I've got to tell you this.
You make me want to kiss. Your endless curiosity is fast becoming tiresome. Knowledge dear is power, and time you acquire some.
You'll be swiftly on.
Eve!
Adam! Eve!
We've got to hide.
No, Adam!
Hurry!
Adam? Why do you hide from me?
I'm ashamed, Father.
Ashamed?
He was ashamed of me, Father.
Oh. So, you tasted the fruit?
Yes, but it's all right. It didn't hurt me after all. And now, my head is so full of impossible dreams. How to fly with the eagles and see in the dark like the owls. Oh, Father, I can see so clearly now. I can see what you can see.
Thank you. endings. I want to cross my hands.
Resist the spell of one seductive tree.
We still love you.
When all around you, I give you fields to roam, sapphire stars and growing waterfalls. All that I had to give, I gave to you.
But Father, didn't you think we would ever grow up?
Why did you disobey me?
That's not an answer.
They're your own children. Answer for yourselves.
We will.
Thank you.
Father put us here as a punishment. If we're good and careful and showing how much we love him, one day he'll forgive us.
I thought this was our home.
This is our home.
I know. Why don't you two go play? So I'll start with her.
Come on, Cain. One, two, three, outside in the tree. Four, five, six, foxes in the sticks. Six, five, four, goslings on the shore. Three, two, one, now we all go home.
Try to go home.
Thank you.
Abel, now's our chance. Mama and Papa are down by the river. I packed the provisions. Come on, we can be miles away by nightfall.
I'm not coming.
Oh, Father, these gifts may you receive to thank you.
Brother, come with me. We can't stay here rotting away forever.
Here we are, your grateful children. Please accept our sacrifice.
Oh, joke. The best of our heart is going up in smoke. Praying for a future from the silent stone shells. How much more of this must we take? This is the morning we finally make a future for ourselves.
But Cain, if it's God's will, we were put here.
Is it God's will, or have we all been caught? Brother, we will never know. We will never grow if we never go.
But we promised Cain.
We wouldn't be the first ones to break a promise. I never made this world. I didn't even lose it. And I know no one said it was fair. But they had a garden once. They had the chance to choose it. They gave it away, including my share. And now we're lost in the wilderness. Lost, crying in the wilderness. And if anyone's watching, they could care less. We're lost.
You should be.
You follow all the rules. You swallow all the stories. And every night you wish on a star. Dreaming your day will come. Trusting in allegories. And every morning you are looking where you are. Lost in the wilderness. Lost, slowly dying in the wilderness.
In you, I place my hope.
Well, Papa said you'd forgive us, Grandfather, and take us all back to the garden.
We're not going back to the garden, Abel.
What?
There is no garden. Not for us, is there?
Come here, my son. I'll return soon, and when I do, I will bring you a gift. For both of you. I will bring you both wives.
Wives?
Of our own?
Cain. Why can't we choose wives for ourselves?
Cain!
I shall choose you the perfect wife. And then you can start your own family and give me my first great grandson.
Why should I give you anything?
You must have faith in me.
Like my father had faith in you? Why don't you come back now? To stop us from leaving?
I'm here to keep you safe.
I don't need you to keep me safe. Did you really think I'd be here chanting a prayer? Till the day you finally deign to reappear. Now that you can say you can stop me from heading out there, when all I know about you is you left us here. A giant ring of stones.
But how did they get here?
People must have brought them here.
Yes, people, other people.
But how can there be other people?
All of my life, happiness this I've been seeking. Been up inside me like an underground spring. Finally a future, finally an answer. Written in a ring of stones. Finally proof from what I've always known. We are not alone. Damn.
Tell him, brother. Go.
Cain! Father came to see us. He came to spy on his grandchildren. He didn't want to see you.
Abel, is this true?
No.
Liar.
No. Good. I'll be better off without him. Get out of my way.
You're not going anywhere.
Is this what it means to be a father? Crushing the spirit of your children like an egg. Is that what it means to be a father? Binding them to you with a chain around the
leg.
Adam! Get out of my way, old man! Never, Papa!
Adam!
I'll kill you, okay?
Thank you. once more. Just once. Tell me what happened to Cain, Father. It's all I want to know. It's all Adam ever wanted to know. I know you can hear me. I know it. When Abel was killed, I knew I would never see Cain again. But Adam would never believe it. Every day I'd watch him standing there in the field, searching the hills for a sign of Cain coming home. He never came. I don't know even today whether he's alive or dead. You're not going to tell me, are you? We had a second chance with Seth. A wonderful boy, just like Adam, naming and numbering everything in sight. At 17, he often disappeared without a word, scared us both half to death. Came back 2 weeks later with a girl from some tribe over the mountains. They had 7 children in as many years. 2 sets of twins! I don't know how she manages. And then one day, Adam died. Suddenly, no warning. Just fell over in the field and didn't get up. We buried him by the waterfall. Was that the right thing to do, Father? Father! Three of Seth's children are married already. I had my first great-grandchild last year. So, I wish Adam could have seen her. We farm the whole valley now, half the range of mountains to itself. But once a year, the whole family comes together at harvest time to give thanks to you, Father, and to remember Adam. Father? Father?
My daughter.
Why can't I see you?
You'll see me soon enough.
Then it's time for me to die?
It's nearly.
Tell me, Father. Is Cain still alive?
Cain is alive.
And did he find some happiness?
He found some happiness.
Thank you, Father.
No thanks to me.
Father!
Yes. My child.
I missed you.
Don't cry, my child. You have done well. You have born Seth, a strong new life. In Seth and his family, I place my hope.
But what if they disappoint you too, Father? What will you do then?
No more questions, Auli’i. It's time to sleep.
Dear children, this will be my last harvest. My father has called me home.
Home? What does she mean by home?
Maybe the garden is still there. Maybe I'll see Adam again. And Abel. Who knows? Like this brief day, my love is nearly gone. But through the night, my children, you will go on. You circumstance.
Thank you. Yes, Father. Have you finished the ark?
Nearly, Father. It's been hard getting parts. Wood is scarce, and I still haven't figured out exactly what a cubit is.
Time is running short, Noah. And your sons, have you chosen wives for them?
Shem and Ham have married, Father.
Women from the tribe of Seth?
Of course, Father.
That is your salvation, Noah. You are perfect in your generations. The blood of your family was never tainted by the race of Cain. Oh, and what of that third son of yours, Japheth? Have you found a wife for him yet?
Yes, several, actually.
He'll only need one.
I know, Father, but he has refused to marry any of them.
Refused?
But now, he says he's found someone.
His father should choose.
I will, of course, but I thought if I chose his choice.
However you do it quickly. Because Japheth will go on the ark alone.
I understand.
Everything has to be perfect.
Yes, Father. But Father.
Yes?
What about the animals? Where are they all going to come from? So many of them are dead now, you know.
Finish the ark and see what you will see.
Riddles. Always riddles.
Finish the ark.
Father.
Yes.
Are you sure?
Noah?
I know we've been through this before. I know you're weary of my asking. But one time more, I stand imploring you. I know you have just cause. With all the faults of humankind, but I think of all the souls, dreams and goals and such, and I try to be resigned. But I wish you'd change your mind. I wish you'd change your mind.
I've watched and waited since the time of Seth, and hoped as each new generation drew its breath. I've hoped forever, now will my world be filled with ungrateful children. I've hoped in vain, grew greedy, violent, they're all the race of Cain. Now only you and your family. This is the last time I will hope. This is the last chance I will give. I will let your family live. But this is the last chance I will give.
Tonight there will be eight. Thank you.
keep looking at your phone. Huh? Put your phone away.
It was here. It was charging.
Thank you. I've been up on the ark, looking around. There's a holder near the bow where you can hide till the rain's over. I'll bring you food, and I'll visit whenever it's safe.
No, Japheth, it's wrong. God told your father the race of Cain must all be destroyed.
Then God must be wrong.
How could God be wrong?
I'm not giving you up.
You can't hide me on the ark forever. What happens when your father finds out, or when God finds out?
I don't care. I don't give a damn for the thunders of fathers, compel our high waters, whatever they do, how can I live in a world without you?
I don't know what to do.
Yonah, in whatever time we have, for as long as we whatever comes, if we face it now as one, I could make it on my own. Let me know that I don't have to. No one really wants to be alone. In whatever time we have, if at times we are afraid, it's all right to feel afraid. I will hope you in the dark. All we know for sure is this: though the world thinks tomorrow, you and I will be together.
Except to make it rain. has come before me. Bring unto the end of time, and let the raging sky sink down and endless rain. I gave everything, out of nothing, now nothing will remain. And to the sky
to visit as soon as I can.
Father, answer me. not going to tell me, are you?
I mean it.
He did. He knew.
Jake, is this true?
What does it matter?
Get her off the ark.
I warned you,
Japheth! Get out of my way, old man! Japheth, ever! Father! I'll kill you!
Japheth!
Come on! I won't be the murderer. I'll leave that to you and to your God. But understand this, all of you, whatever you do to Yonah, you do to the both of us. Throw us overboard, cast us adrift. Whatever you do to her, you do to the both of us. Stop.
That's enough, then.
She can't stop.
That's
it.
Enough, Gobolo.
Mama, there are others.
All of you, now. I want to speak to Papa alone.
Father?
He doesn't speak to you anymore, does he? Not since before the rain.
No. Now I don't know what he wants. Is he asking me to sacrifice my son? Why else would he abandon us?
I don't know about God. He never said anything to me anyway. But if he has abandoned us, then the whole world is just this little family adrift on a big wooden boat with a lot of animals. You must be the father now. You must be the father.
Father, please don't let me choose. Either way, it's more than I can bear to lose. Oh, this son of mine I love so well, and all the toll it takes, I would give to him a garden and keep it clear of snakes. But the one thing he most treasures is to make his own mistakes. Oh, he goes charging up the cliffs of life, a reckless mountaineer. I can help him not to stumble, I could warn him what to fear. I could shout until I'm breathless, and he'd still refuse to hear. Oh, but you cannot close the acorn once the oak begins to grow. And you cannot close your heart to what it feels and needs to know. That the hardest part of love is the letting go. As a child I found a sparrow that had fallen from its nest, and I nursed it back to health till it was stronger than the rest. But when I tried to hold it, let it pet and scratch my chest till I let it go. And I watched it fly away from me with its bright and selfish song. And a part of me was cursing I had helped it grow so strong. And I feared it might go hungry, and I feared it might go wrong. Oh, but I could not close the acorn once the oak began to grow. And I cannot close my heart for what it fears and needs to know. That the hardest part of love is the letting go. It's only in Eden grows a rose without a thorn, and your children start to leave you on the day that they are born. They will leave you there to cheer for them, they will leave you there to mourn ever so. Like an ark on uncharted seas, their lives begin to toss, and the deeper is your love for them, the cooler is the cost. And just when they start to find themselves, it's when you feel their loss. Oh, but you cannot close the acorn once the oak begins to grow. And you cannot close your heart for what it fears and needs to know. That the hardest part of love, and the rarest part of love, and the truest part of love,
and now there's no time to lose. Japheth, Yonah, stand forward and place your hands on the staff.
So we are to be sacrificed?
Yes, my son. You are.
So be it.
Japheth, Yonah, by the authority of the staff of Adam, carved in the beginning from the tree of knowledge, I sacrifice you to each other. You are now man and wife.
What are you saying, Papa?
They are now a part of this family for as long as we all shall live.
I don't understand.
Did God say it was all right, Papa?
No. As we well know, our end is very near. And God's priorities are no longer clear to me. And so I ask you, if all we've got is just this little while, here and now, every one of us reconciled. Yonah, since the flood began, the blood of Cain has risen up in all of us, but never in you.
Though we fell, so help us stand as we raise a
Speak to us in words. Send us a sign, a covenant between us that we may know the floodwaters will never again return to destroy your earth. Our earth.
Papa, we're all ready.
My children. The time has come for us to divide our ways and begin our journeys. We have no maps, only the ways we wish for ourselves. As for myself and Mom, our journey is already done. We'll stay here and live on in the Ark. But what of the rest of you, Shem, Aisha? What have you decided?
We will go east, Papa, towards the rising sun.
And who will you take with you?
The tigers, the pandas, the elephants with little ears, and any creature that cares to follow.
And Ham, and Afra, and little Eve. Where will you go?
South. Across the desert no one has crossed.
And who will you take with you?
The lions, the ostriches, the elephants with big ears, any other creature that cares to follow.
And so to Japheth and Renée. What have you decided? Will you go west?
There's only water to the west. Everybody knows that.
Then north?
Only a fool would want to live in the north.
We will go west and north and east and south until we found our home. And what is the home you will search for, Japheth? My son.
Eden.
We will search for Eden.
The longest journey of all.
Then you, of all our children, will have most need of this. When you find Eden, take this, the staff of Adam. Plant it firmly in the ground, and it will grow once more. Tend its blossoms for prayer. And as they turn to fruit, harvest the fruit and eat of the fruit of the tree of knowledge. And give to your children that they may freely eat. This is my gift to you. And your children. And your children's children. Forever.
Farewell, my precious children. In your hands I place the key to this prison made of gratitude, which has held you close.
at last.